reflection
to
the white people, reflection.
To those that flew the aircraft, for 30 years, this was the peacekeeper of this country. Gentlemen, I ought to say that this aircraft will probably be the largest military aircraft that will ever be constructed in this country that's all British. Today, aircraft are a consortium of countries that put aircraft together. This is a true British aircraft, and it represents a peacekeeper for nearly 30 years. It was the aircraft that was there at the Cuban crisis. It was there at the Falklands. And hopefully, with the spirit of the people and the will of the political will of the government, through Mr. Harry Greenway, through the petition, the government will see that this aircraft is part of British heritage and should remain as such.
I'm receiving this petition in response to enormous public pressure and support for the saving of this great aircraft, the final example of it. I've talked to the Minister of Defence, who says that a sum of money will be required to keep it here, and it will be important to raise more money yet to ensure that the aircraft remains in this country. And the petitioners are strong in their view that it is part of the British heritage, and in Britain it must remain.
It is an aircraft that can be maintained in a near airworthy condition. With advancing technology in aviation, there will be a time when it will be flown. And my last word is to say, the Royal Air Force wish to keep this aircraft, wish to keep it so that it represents part of their living history. And this aircraft will do a great deal in the future. It will fundraise not only for charities, but one of the most important charities, the Royal Air Force Benevolent Fund. And long may it do that role. It deserves a better fate than going under auction and being scrapped. It deserves, it's got a past, it's got a fine past, and it should have a fine future. And it'll be up to us, the general members of the public, to ensure that occurs.
Gentlemen, there are 250,000 signatures. And there will now be a press conference in room W3 for anybody who'd like to come to it. But if you have anything you'd like to ask now, you might prefer to put any points here. All right.
Any questions?
Could you like to? Any more?
We're hoping we will be, because you, the great British public, are representing the will that will get this, hopefully, changed by the government.
Thank you.
I wish we could have the Balkan and eat it.